What is going on, guys and gals? My name is Ben Kirsch, and I am so excited to show you this new lesson that I've been working on. Okay, so this entire lesson is based on a really classic drum book called, if I can get it, Stick Control by George Lawrence Stone. Stick Control for the Snare Drummer by George Lawrence Stone. So I've been sleeping on this book for absolutely way too long. I always thought of it as a rudimentary book that my middle school drum teacher used to work with me on, and I never really thought there was any application for it on drum set or in my playing now, and boy was I wrong. And if you just look at all of the amazing drummers that have testimonials in here, the list is endless. Now, I knew from reading interviews of Tony Williams back when he was still with us, Billy Cobham talked about working through this book, David Garibaldi from Tower of Power, Steve Gadd, you can just go on, Virgil Donati, Steve Smith, the list is endless. And you can really, when you start working out of this, you can really hear how this book has influenced their playing. We are going to start on the first page of exercises, right here on page 5. And as you can see, this whole page is nothing but stickings and eighth notes. That's all it is. Just combinations of rights and lefts. And we are going to be looking specifically at number 5 through 8. So 5, 6, 7, and 8. So just 4 exercises. Okay, so the first thing that we are going to do here is we are going to take each of these and just play it on the snare drum as written. That's the first thing you want to do, because you want to get comfortable with these patterns before you start applying it to the drum set. So that's the first thing we're going to do. So that is the first thing that I would recommend doing. I recommend spending a little bit of time on either just a snare drum or a pad, just getting these patterns and try and build it up to around. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to start trying to make a groove out of these patterns. So we're going to take the first one, number 5, which is just a paradiddle, and we're going to take the right hand and we're going to put it on the hi-hat, and we're going to take the left hand and we're going to put it on the snare drum. So it's going to sound something like this. So the next step is we're going to take that pattern and we're going to add a backbeat to it. So it's going to be something like this. We're going to put the backbeat on 3. And then we're going to put the kick drum on 1. It's very important that you keep the non-accented snare notes as ghost notes, very low, around like 1 to 3 inches off the snare. So you have a nice meaty rim shot as an accent, and then just a small little tap for the ghost notes. Okay, so now I'm just gonna play through each exercise with a kick drum on 1 and a backbeat on 3. Thank you. So after you spend some time with that and you feel comfortable, now it's time to start adding some more kick drums. So now we're going to add a kick drum from each right hand of each exercise. All right, so I'm going to take the metronome, I'm going to slow it back down to 80, and we'll do that. So then, once you get comfortable with doing that, with adding the kick drums on the right hands, now it's time to start messing around with the accents. So what I like to do is I like to take the accents on the left hand and just kind of move it around. It's kind of hard to explain. Let me just demonstrate it, and I'll put the stickings somewhere around here. So we're going to take that same concept of moving the accent around on the left hand, and we're going to apply that to each different exercise. Okay, so I already did number 5, so I'm going to do number 6, and number 7, and number 8. this is some tough stuff. This is not easy at all. And like anything with your drumming, always take it super slow in the beginning and always with a metronome at whatever tempo you're doing. Okay, so there's only one more part to this exercise, this whole concept, this whole thing that we're doing, and that is taking these grooves and playing them as non-linear grooves. So right now, the hands are linear, right? And we're playing each of these. The hands are playing different things. So now, what we're gonna do is we're gonna take the right hands and we're gonna make them kick drums. We're gonna keep the left hands as snares, and we're gonna play eighth notes or quarter notes, but I'm reading this as 16th notes, so I would say eighth notes. So yeah, let me demonstrate that real quick. So that's what I'm talking about, taking all of these and making them into non-linear grooves. Same accent concept with the linear groove. Thank you. so thank you so much for watching. Please, if you can, subscribe to the channel and turn on push notifications so you get an update whenever I do a new video. Check out my website, backbaydrumming.com. If any of you guys are interested in studying with me or taking any private lessons, you can contact me at backbaydrumming@gmail.com. Also, if you just have any general questions about any lessons or anything that I do, don't hesitate to send me an email. All right, cool. Take care.